Have you ever thought, wow, I have imposter syndrome. I am truly not capable of doing a programming job, but I really need that paycheck and I don't want anyone to catch on. Well, you should probably fix that problem before someone actually does catch on. But until then, what if there was a way to hide in plain sight? What if there was a way to make it look like you're doing work, but you're not? Here we have a tool called Rust Stakeholder. As you might expect from the name, it is written in Rust. But far more important is what it does. If we go and run Rust-Stakeholder, it is going to generate absolute nonsense. However, convincing-looking developer-y kind of nonsense. And as someone who knows what they're looking at, you know, it's garbage. However, if we're talking about someone in management who has no idea what your job even is, even though it's doing absolutely nothing, it looks like you're waiting for something important to happen. And if the goal is to be just convincing enough to not get fired, well, you know, at least for a couple of days, this might work. But by default, this is very generic backend kind of output, and you might not be a backend developer. So what you want to do is customize it to make it fit in your kind of environment. This can be done with the dash D option. We can also check what we can use with dash H. So we can have, by default, it is set to backend. We have frontend, full stack, data science, DevOps, blockchain, machine learning, systems programming, game development, and security. Now, a lot of the output you're going to see here is going to be the same, right? It's going to be loading configuration files and basic things which most environments are going to have. But a lot of the later text is going to talk about things that sound more specific to that environment. Like in security, we're going to talk about encryption and permissions and things like that, and benchmarking encryption performance. If we go over to the game development one, when you control C out, it actually does have to finish the current stage you're in, so it does take a little bit longer. If we go to game development, again, it's going to start off loading configuration files, things like that. But once it gets into the next stage, then we're going to start seeing things like frame rate optimization, Unity, physics simulations, and other things which sound somewhat convincing. Again, it is complete nonsense. But it doesn't have to be good. It just has to be good enough to not get you fired immediately. Now, to be a true developer in the eyes of management, we need more jargon. The less the management understands, the more work you're obviously doing. This is done with the dash J option. By default set to medium, we could go to high, but let's go straight to extreme. Now, different sections you run are going to have different kinds of jargon and different levels of jargon, but in the game development space, we see things like optimizing asset streaming, implemented batching for 2x performance improvement, lots of things that seem like you're doing work, draw call count, memory fragmentation ratio, lots of API calls to simulate the multiplayer connections. Hey? Now, jargon is important, but maybe even more important is the amount of things happening on the screen. More things, more work, more not getting fired. This is controlled with the dash C option for complexity. Again, by default, set to medium. Instead of going to high, let's go to extreme. Now, initially, it's gonna look pretty similar. I wish I could skip the first stage just for the sake of demonstration. And now it's just going to start racing through these things. It's not a ton faster, but it is definitely faster than when it was just running as medium. Again, more things means more work. Now, up until this point, I've been canceling it using Control-C. If for whatever reason you have a need to stop it earlier than that. This is controlled with the dash capital T option set in seconds. Zero is the default. Zero means run forever. But let's say I want to run it for 5 seconds. And it should completely ignore what the setting does. Oh, it ended. That was definitely not 5 seconds. It did end though. Now, in a real pipeline, sometimes things go wrong, sometimes things need to be fixed. If we add the dash A option, this is going to include alerts. Now, when and if they show up is very random. So I don't know if I'm gonna notice one that's here, but there should theoretically... here we go. Right here. There should be one. It's a very subtle change that doesn't really add that much, but it makes your nonsense just a little bit more convincing. On that note, what you also probably want to do is fix this right here, the name of the project, because sure, maybe you're working on something known as distributed cluster, but that's not going to be the case for most people. With the dash P option, we can set the name of this. Let's call it Doodoo. It can be literally anything you want. And with the dash capital F option, we can also set a name for the framework. Let's call it Best Framework. And now at the top right here, Project Doodoo Framework, Best Framework. Now it's up for debate whether this is or is not a good change to make. If we include dash dash minimal, this is going to have a less colorful output, not a entirely colorless output. Things like the headings and the loading bar are still going to be colored, but everything else is going to be removed. Frankly, I would have liked an option where it removes all of the color and it's just a giant wall of text, but I guess, you know what? I guess the subtle use of color might make it seem like those parts are a lot more important than just having everything being colored. I don't know, it's definitely up for debate though. Now let's take a look at the GitHub page because this has some absolute gold on it as well. Become an irreplaceable 10x developer in 30 seconds flat. Why stop at 10x? Why not be a 100x or a 1000x developer? Why learn actual skills when you can just look impressive instead? Introducing Rust Stakeholder, a CLI tool that generates absolutely meaningless but impressive looking terminal output to convince everyone you're a coding genius without writing a single line of useful code. Remember, it's not about your actual contribution to the code base, it's about how complicated your terminal looks when the VP of engineering walks by. Nothing says I'm vital to this company like 15 progress bars, cryptic error messages you seem unfazed by, and technical jargon nobody understands. Features that add zero value but look incredibly important. Dazzling development simulations, making it look like you're solving CERN-level computing problems when you're actually just refreshing Reddit. Meaningless jargon generator, impressed with phrases like implemented non-Euclidean topology optimization for multidimensional data representation. No, it doesn't mean anything. Convincing progress bars. Nothing says I'm working like a progress bar slowly advancing while you're in the break room. To be fair, this is actually... how a lot of early development was done. Things would take so long to compile that people would actually go on their lunch break whilst the compilation is happening. Fake network activity. Simulate mission-critical API requests that are actually just a computer talking to itself. Artificial crisis mode. Generate realistic-looking alerts so people think you're heroically averting disasters. Imaginary team activity. Pretend your invisible friends are sending you important pull requests. And domain chameleon. Switch between backend, frontend, blockchain, and seven other domains faster than you can say full-stack developer. The benefits. Promotion fast track. Skip the tedious, delivering value step entirely. Meeting domination. Let it run in the background during calls to seem busy. deadline extensions. Sorry, still resolving those critical system alerts. Salary negotiation. Just leave it running during your review. And job security. Become the only person who seems to understand your fictional systems. Now, in case it wasn't clear from the very start, this is satire. This is a joke. Don't actually use it to fake actually being good at your job. It's just some fun. But if you do it, let me know. So if for whatever reason you liked the video, that's cool. Go like the video down below. Let me know in the comment section down below as well. How would you use this tool? And have you used a tool like this? Or have you done something to pretend like you're doing work? I know during a lot of people doing remote work, people were using mouse shakers. So I'd love to hear your stories. If you like the video, I said that. If you really like the video and you want to become one of these amazing people over here, check out the Patreon, Scribes, Lily Berapay, link in the description down below. That's going to be it for me, and I want to know. I really want to know. Like this.